Teletubbies. Time for Teletubbies. Time for Teletubbies.
Tingy winky,
I was ringing up a dad and son, and the first thing I noticed about them is they were both wearing t-shirts with fish on them, so I knew they were probably used to catching shit, and I was definitely not about to let them catch an attitude. So the dad stopped me as I was ringing things up, and he said, whoa, that's supposed to be on sale. And I was like, oh, okay, just let me rescan it. And so I rescanned it, and the price was just like my weight. It just wasn't getting any lower. So I looked at him, and I was like, this price is stagnant. And he was like, okay, we'll get someone else over here. So my coworker came over and she scanned the item and manually entered the item number, and the price just wasn't moving. And then the dad decided to elbow the son and go, haha, how many women does it take to scan an item? And then he elbowed him again and decided to repeat the joke, and I was just sitting there like, dang, you about to bruise his ribs. So then the dad took us to where he saw the sale sign, and lo and behold, there was a sale sign, but it was for a completely different product. So I looked at him and I said, see, this sign is actually for a different product, as you can see printed on here. And then I elbowed my coworker and said, haha, how many men does it take to read a sign?
When I was 13, I lived next door to this super cool and beautiful girl named Stephanie. And Stephanie was very popular and always hanging out with her friends at her house. So whenever I was bored at my house, my mom would be like, why don't you go over to Stephanie's? And I'd be like, Mom! Stephanie would never want to hang out with me. But then one day, Stephanie knocked on my door and was like, hey Lydia, I'm having a bonfire in my backyard tonight if you want to come by. So that night, I went over to Stephanie's backyard. So I was chilling, sitting by the campfire, playing it cool. But then, one of Stephanie's friends, Shelby, was like, my butt hurts from sitting in the grass. David, I'm gonna come sit in your lap. And then all of the girls decided that they were gonna sit in the boys' laps. And there was one boy left, Tyler, and it felt like everyone was expecting me to go sit in Tyler's lap. So I go sit down in Tyler's lap, and it's all very exciting because I've never sat in a boy's lap before. And then someone says something funny, and I start laughing. But the pressure of my laughter causes a long, loud fart to escape from my 13-year-old butthole. And everyone goes silent. And then Stephanie goes, did someone just fart? And Tyler goes, I think it was Lydia. And I go, no, it wasn't, but I think I'm gonna go home now. And now it's been 12 years since I farted in Tyler's lap, and I still think about it at least once a week. When adults tell you that certain things won't be embarrassing when you get older, they're lying.
I want to be with my real mom and dad. I want you to let me go.
Is that any way to talk to your mother?
You aren't my mother.
Apologize at once, Coraline.
No.
I'll give you to the count of three. One. Two.
Three! Ow! What are you doing? Ow, that hurts!
This girl literally lived a nightmare. A 17-year-old girl was watching TV late at night when her motion detector lights in her driveway suddenly went on. She assumed it was just an animal, so she got up, drew the blinds, and went back to watching TV. Then a little bit later, it happened again. Before she could even react, she looks over and clearly makes out a silhouette of a person right behind the blinds who starts banging aggressively on the window. The girl stands up and goes, I'm gonna call the cops! And the figure stops for just a second, sprints to the side door, and starts pounding even louder on that, screaming incoherently. The girl runs to the bathroom, barricades herself inside while she waits for the police, and then her worst nightmares come true. She hears glass shatter in the other room. After a few minutes of silence, she opens her door just a crack to get a peek outside, and standing in her living room next to a broken window is some crazy old woman who looks over at her and starts sprinting toward her. The lady comes smashing into the door and starts wailing on it until the police arrive and take her away. She was a lunatic who had escaped her facility.
You're looking at over 8 hours worth of work. Look at that shine. Look at that detail. Look at these necklaces. It takes 2 seconds. Share, copy link. Like the video. Give me a follow. That's all I need.
In high school, I had a friend who lived in this old, small apartment building. And on the first floor was this old guy named Dave who had apparently lived in the building forever. And no one really knew what Dave's deal was. The only time people saw him is when he walked outside to walk his tiny dog. But other than that, he never left his apartment. He had a nephew who delivered him groceries once a week. My friend just assumed that Dave was too old or had some sort of sickness that prevented him from leaving the house. One day, my friend was coming home from school and Dave's nephew was leaving the apartment building. And my friend is really sweet, so she was like, hey, I know Dave sometimes has troubles getting out of the house, so if you ever need me to go over there and bring him something, let me know. I'm always happy to help. And the nephew looked really shocked and terrified. He was like, no, you should never go over to Dave's ever. And then he got really awkward and he was like, okay, gotta go, bye. And then a few weeks later, my friend was coming home from a Halloween party late at night. And when she got inside her apartment building, Dave's door on the first floor was wide open and it was pitch black inside his apartment. But then she heard something behind her.
So she said, what's the problem, baby? What's the problem? I don't know. Well, maybe I'm in love. I think about it every time I think about it. Can't stop thinking about it. How much longer will it take to cure this? Just to cure it, cause I can't ignore it. If it's love, it makes me wanna turn around and face me. But I don't know nothing about love. Come on, come on. Turn a little faster. Come on, come on. The world will follow after. Come on, come on. Cause everybody's after love. So I said, I'm a snowball running. Running down into the
The only way to get what you want is to become a human yourself.
Can you do that?
My dear, sweet child, that's what I do. It's what I live for, to help unfortunate merfolk like yourself. Poor souls with no one else to turn to. I admit that in the past I've been a nasty. They weren't kidding when they called me, well, a witch. But you'll find that nowadays I've mended all my ways, repented, seen the light, and made a switch. True, yes. And I fortunately know a little magic. It's a talent that I always have possessed. And dear lady, please don't laugh. I use it on behalf of the miserable, lonely, and depressed. Pathetic. Poor unfortunate.